All right, many thanks for still staying with us. This is Morning at NTV, and you're with me, Malaki Vilodera. Of course, we do this with Romeo Busiku. You can tag us directly at just that across all the social media platforms. We're also live on air and on social media as well. Just head on to NTV Uganda, Facebook or YouTube, and you'll find the Morning at NTV live stream right there. So just in case you're stepping out, you absolutely have no excuse. We're getting into a big conversation for the day, of course, Kickstarter, and we're seeking your views on this one because you will be the one to be directly affected by this. Now, Uganda has passed yet another law on physical planning, and it includes public littering. This time round, the act enforcing tough repercussions for the guilty party. Now, any person, hear this clearly, any person found littering risks paying a fine of, hear this, 2 million Uganda shillings. Also, the guilty party could be jailed for a period not exceeding 1 year or both. And this is according to the Physical Planning Amendment Act No. 2 of 2020, passed by Parliament Tuesday. Now, this wouldn't, of course, isn't the first time that we are seeing some of the strict declarations that have been made to clamp down on the littering, of course, in the city and in the country. In 2012, we did see the 2012, of course, in 2012, Kampala City, of course, the KCCA, the Kampala City Council Authority, passed a strict ban on littering, which carried a fine of, hear this again, 40,000 Uganda shillings. And it was just not just that. Now, they were saying that over and above that, that you'll be in prison for about 2 months. And then over and above that, you'll be subjected to 20 hours of community service. So we're asking, will this be any different? To have that conversation in studios, I'm joined by none other but Mr. Emmanuel Kaganzi. He is the Commissioner of Planning, Physical Planning at the Ministry of Lands, Housing and Urban Development. Many thanks.
My pleasure.
Welcome to Morning at NTV.
Thank you. Good morning, viewers.
Good morning. Just give us some brief background on how this came into play. Now, we are having the Physical Planning Amendment Act No. 2 of 2020. Of course, we did see the 2012 KCCA kind of ban law, whereby, like I said, if you're found guilty of littering in the city or just anywhere around, you know, the country, you will be subjected to a maximum of 2 months in prison. Over and above that, 20 hours of community service, and over and above that, you also be fined 40,000 Uganda shillings. Wasn't this enough? Why did we need another law for this?
Yeah, thank you so much. First of all, I would like to give you the background. There has been an existing law of Physical Planning Act 2020. Mm-hmm. And this is amendment, meaning this amendment is to reinforce and pad some gaps that have been there in 2020 law. So in reinforcing this 2020, this 2010 Physical Planning Act, there was amendment. And this is one of the amendments that were made, whereby it is deriving it from even the Constitution of Uganda, whereby everybody has a right to a clean environment. Mm-hmm. You are talking about littering. Littering is one of the things that make our environment untidy. So in way of having, this is a situation where we intend to have clean urban environment. So in a way, enforce that, we had to regulate it. Mm-hmm. And by regulating it is that we had to include it in the Physical Planning Amendment Act of 2020, whereby there are offenses and charges that were spelled out. So one of them is that if one is founding making our environment untidy, he will be charged or prosecuted. Mm-hmm. So this one is different because it is under different law. It reinforces the laws that have been there, and it will work in tandem with other laws.
All right. So who will be the enforcer on this one? Is it KCCA?
Yeah, this is a law that covers the whole country.
Right.
And within the whole country, every area has authorities. For example, the KCCA will enforce within Kampala.
Right.
Mukono within Kampala, because this is the law that applies to every part of the country. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So it's KCCA. And then the fine that we're looking at this time round is not any lean penny. We're looking at 2 million Uganda shillings, a penalty for anyone who is found guilty of littering. So who will be collecting these monies? What will be the due process? Just assume, paint a picture for us. I'm found guilty of littering. And according to the stipulated law now is that I stand to be fined 2 million Uganda shillings or stand to be jailed or imprisoned for nothing less than a year. So in the money aspect, paint a picture for us. If today me as Malaki Vilodera, I'm found guilty, what happens? And the manufacturer, who collects it?
Yeah, of course, as I've told you that each area has an authority which enforces the law. Right now, we are preparing the regulations. And those regulations will have to cover all those aspects. But currently, now the law is in force, the enforcer, the authority within the area of jurisdiction, is the one charged in collection of that revenue.
Okay. So in the case of Kampala, it will be KCCA.
Sure.
Where will this money go to?
Of course, it goes to the authority. And I've told you that we are under formulation of the regulations that will handle all those aspects.
Okay. So it's still work in progress.
Absolutely.
Okay. Because, of course, every Ugandan would want to have that information, because they always say that at times we found ourselves in trouble just because we didn't have the information.
Sure.
And at times we are swindled just because we don't know what the due process is. For example, if I'm told it's 2 million, then it's KCCA collecting if it's in Kampala. Then you don't know, where should I pay the 2 million? If at all I pay it, will there be some documentation that will act as some proof of payment or something like that to curb the conversation of corruption and swindling?
Absolutely. The government has a system of collecting money, of dispensing money. There are laws even concerned with that. Mm-hmm. But, and as you said, every Ugandan has a right to be informed. And as I told you, this is a new law that has come into place. Dissemination of it is starting, and in fact now it is being disseminated. People have to know that there is a law in place, and they have to be very well informed of the offenses committed in breach of this law.
Mm-hmm.
So as a ministry, we are putting up measures to widely disseminate this law for people to understand.
Okay.
And get the right information.
All right.
Yes.
And once the due process bit of the payment comes through, you also inform the Ugandans.
Absolutely, that is their right to be
informed.
Because
you always know that in any sack of potatoes, there's always the rotten potatoes who would want to leverage on some of these things.
Absolutely.
All right. So now the other question, of course, a majority of Ugandans were having once this came into the public domain is that we did have the 2012 KCC, of course, kind of law that I stipulated before, whereby if you're found littering, it was, 20 hours of community service, 2 months of imprisonment, and then there was an affordable figure there of a fine of 40,000 Uganda shillings. Where did this end? Is it now being subdued with a new law?
Of course, under the process of laws and regulations, now this law has come into play. It will apply.
Which one will apply? The current one?
The current one.
So the 2012 one is now null and void? Do we say that categorically?
I can't say that categorically it is null and void, but we are going to work in harmony with KCCA and other authorities, because that is the law that was applying only in KCCA.
Mm-hmm.
But this is a law that applies across the country.
Mm-hmm.
So we are under these regulations we are going to make, we are going to consult and have all that one streamlined and get people informed who will be the ones to pay that money in case they are at fault.
All right. Yes. When I look at this just practically, the one for 2012 was more lenient, but it served the purpose. Because over and above just, being in prison and paying a fine, you are supposed to, be involved in 20 hours of community service. And I think it's in that community service that you get to understand, your mindset is changed, and you get to understand what ideally littering is and the consequences of littering and also what it does to the environment. So there's an education caveat to that. Mm-hmm. Don't you think that is missing in the new law? Whereby, fine, it's more stringent. I would say it's more deterrent, so to speak, because 2 million, who would come by that kind of money as a fine? It's quite deterrent. Mm. However, the learning aspect whereby this person is actually, you know, like a remedial kind of factor whereby you now understand where your wrong is and how your action, you know, has a long-term repercussion to the environmental kind of degradation. So don't you think that factor is missing in here?
Well, you see, somehow, somewhere, a law is supposed to be prohibitive. So we are prohibiting this kind of device, which is not welcoming in our community, which has destroyed an environment. And a destroyed environment is a cost to our side. So the cost of a destroyed environment is far beyond whatever kind of money. But nevertheless, I understand that one, and now that this law has been in place, it has been passed, consultations were made, and we are telling people it is very stringent and it is stinging, so please don't litter.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you will pay this kind of hefty money.
All right.
Which is not easy, definitely, to come by.
Of course.
I understand.
I think a majority will just be imprisoned on this one, because not every Ugandan will come across 2 million Uganda shillings.
But not everybody will and now they will stop littering.
They will stop littering. Hopefully, you think
stop,
so?
They will stop littering.
All right. Mm. Now,
of course, the law is there to change the situation.
Right. Mm. The education factor, does it concern you that you might end up having people who are, you know, shunning littering but not understanding the core as to why they ought not to litter? I'll give you an example. There's this street that I pass by every single morning and evening. Mm. And the area residents, I can't categorically say if it's KCCA that has put that particular poster there, where they say that if you litter here, if you dump your trash here and found, you know, then you will be subject to be fined, and I think they put, is it 200K in
even
that particular street? Even others 500, it
million.
Varies.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there's a time whereby when that was introduced, people shunned from it. A week down the line, that poster was removed, and people had started continuing to litter in that particular space. Of course, meaning that they didn't understand why they ought not to litter or dump their, you know, trash in that particular spot, you know. So that bit of educating the masses, helping them to understand, because you all believe that if you understand something, then you become a better steward, don't you think so?
Absolutely, and really, one of our major objectives is to sensitize the community about that law. When we are sensitizing, we are educating, we are informing people. We are trying to work on the what I can call the mindset change.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so meaning that the education part of it, as we are disseminating this law, we shall be sensitizing people. We shall be educating people. We shall be. And every local government, every authority shall be charged to sensitize,
mm-hmm.
to make people understand the laws and the repercussions. I think the education and the mindset change of it will be embedded into this campaign
All right.
of sensitization, disseminating and making people aware of what is the law.
Okay, and I think there's a question coming to you directly. Of course, we are live on Facebook, we are live on YouTube. There's a question coming through from Carissa. No, there's one coming through from John Kuss. He's saying, good morning. The law is made, but details are not clear, and we're not sure of the avenues that this communication will be dispensed to the rest of Ugandans.
Yes.
So I think break that down. If you're saying that the education bit will be a critical, you know, aspect of this. And you're saying that you make sure that every Ugandan is enlightened and understands. Mm. So what channels will you be using to dispense this information to every Ugandan now that this law will be effective across all the regions in the country?
Yes, of course, as I told you, that every Ugandan has a right to know, and most especially whatever is in the law. Mm-hmm. So we have different channels. This law will be made in two popular versions, will be made, we shall use media channels, print, and us ourselves, we shall go out to the communities. We cannot reach at each and every community. We shall use our offices at different local governments. Mm-hmm. But those local governments, first of them, they have to understand the law, what they will dispense to the people.
Okay.
So it is up to us. And we are open to each and everybody, that whoever needs this information, first of all, our office is open, and this is now a public document.
All right.
So whichever method, whichever channel that is available to us, we shall use it.
Okay.
But most especially, we shall have to have a popular version of these laws.
All right. Another concern coming through still on Facebook Live, Ismail Tuaha, he's saying they should first think of putting the mechanisms in place, enabling mechanisms like disposable bins or designated areas within the community where people can dispose of their trash and do the sensitization. I think you've already weighed in on the sensitization bit.
Yes, yes.
Talk to the mechanisms, the disposing mechanisms, whereby you also enable the community to comply, like putting bins in place and all these other structures.
Yes. Before that, I think the mechanism are there. Walk along the streets. KCC has tried to put bins in most convenient areas. But people pass by the bin and litters anyway. Even if he's moving, but he passes by the bin and litters anyway. Isn't that the mechanism that KCC has put in place?
But is it good enough? On a scale of 1 to 10, honestly, Mr. Edward, Emmanuel, beg your pardon, on a scale of 1 to 10, in terms of how well KCCA has placed these bins, where would you put them at?
You see, now, this is
because the streets I pass through and I just can't. Yes, especially that location where I'm telling you, there was that particular, you know, poster whereby there was a fine that you, of course, you'd be subjected to once you're found guilty. To date, they haven't put any bin.
All right, then those are some cases. And I think any convenient place that is suit for a bin to be sited there, it should be there. Okay? But the few which are there, are they utilized very well?
Mm-hmm.
Are they expected? Mm-hmm. So this is where I'm telling you, there is that kind of mindset change, where people should change some behavior and know that this is a bin, and littering all over is not good.
All right.
For our city.
On a scale of 1 to 10, where would you put KCCA at?
I think I can leave it the public opinion. And
you're gauges, staying safe on this one.
And the gauge are such that we know how to improve.
All right.
But the principle of mechanism, yes, that one is very, very good.
Mm-hmm.
And efforts have been put in place. We have policies, we have guidelines, and now the actions, they need maybe to be stepped up, and definitely we welcome public ideas on how to improve on that.
You know, personally, I get disturbed when I pass through a street that is littered.
The good
thing you mentioned, angered.
Get disturbed.
Yes, and I also now, on the other level, I get angered whenever I see a car passing through and the driver or the person inside the car just throwing a wrapper or a bottle into the roads. And for me, I always say, okay, Mala, calm down. Maybe they just don't know.
Mm.
When I find trash dumped in a non-designated area, I also get disturbed. And I always say, calm down. Maybe we don't know. Now that you're here and you're an authority in that particular space, inform us today. if I'm living in a residential area, and of course any residential area, any business space generates trash,
waste,
for lack of a better word. Enlighten us today. Is the onus on the authorities to make sure that they give us ways and mechanisms on how we can dispose of our waste well enough? Or is it onus on us as, of course, the people living in this residential area or the occupants of this business complex? Is the onus on us to ensure that we come up with mechanisms of disposing of our waste well enough? Who should take the mantle on this one?
Yeah, well, you see, waste management is a wide thing. It right all starts from generation. Where it is generated, it has to be transported to a disposable site.
Mm-hmm.
So those are stages. For example, you are the one who generates the waste.
Correct.
Okay. And you are asked to put that waste in a convenient place. KCCA or other service providers are there to transport your waste.
Mm-hmm.
KCCA or any authority has designated areas of disposal, you see? So, me, I have a responsibility as an individual. My local government has a responsibility of providing a landing site, a disposable site, where all the collected waste should be disposed.
Mm-hmm.
Then, the public and the government have also a responsibility in transporting that generated waste to the disposal.
So it's the onus is on government to transform, to transport this waste from my home or from my business complex to the designated area of disposal.
Yeah, for example, what if I want to tell you is that waste can be categorized.
Mm-hmm.
Even there is a mechanism of separation. Sometime back here in lands, we tried to bring on the waste bins of different colors and really mark their
plastic paper waste, like that.
So and there is also that due to separation.
Mm-hmm.
So in other words, we don't want to say that government should do this one for me, this one for me. This is where we have to come in. Okay? So they are telling you, if you generate waste, collect it in a bin. Put it in a bin.
Mm-hmm.
Most especially in urban areas, put it in a bin. Then, the service provider, let it be government,
mm-hmm.
let it be private,
mm-hmm.
will come in that, collect that waste from your bin and take it to where government or authority has provided space for you.
Okay.
So it is our duty, us as public,
to be responsible enough.
To be responsible enough and let the government play its part to ensure that the environment is clean.
I hear you. I hear you. Because the areas where KCCA doesn't reach, and I think the people who are watching us today, and they know that they've had to take that responsibility and involve a private player to transport their waste.
Let me just chip in that.
Uh-huh.
Is where it can't reach. Simply because some of the roads we've built in them, the trucks can't pass there.
Mm.
As we've built in them. Some of the areas are inaccessible because the planning, the enforcement has been, of course, lagging.
Isn't that your docket?
It is, and I must make sure that there is a gap in enforcement. And that's the reason why this law has come into place, to ensure we strengthen the systems, we strengthen the structures which are there to enforce such a standard.
My last question to you.
Yes.
You know, your docket is urban development also.
The physical planning
bit.
Yes, and urban development.
Yes, when are we going to see a change in how Kampala looks like in terms of the development? Every single day, like you categorically say, at times KCCA doesn't reach to some of these areas because of the poor planning. There are no sufficient roads for the trucks to get to these particular spots. And Ugandans have been complaining, especially them that live in Kampala. I'll just speak for us in Kampala because Yeah,
that's where you stay.
Exactly, and that's where I can give, you know, an authoritative voice for. We see buildings cropping up every single day. At times, some that, you know, compromise on even the drainage channels. Others that crop up and you're like, how did this get a permit? Honestly, how did the contractors get a permit? So this is your docket. What are you doing with regards to that? And on a scale of 1 to 10 again, where would you put us at in terms of the standard or the expected standard and quality of the city's development?
Yeah, I must say that city development is a process and it changes quite often. And if I may throw you back a question. If you were in Kampala 10 years ago, and you compare it with today, is it changing for the best, for the worst? Is there any kind of improvement? You now, as a person who is living in Kampala. So if it is an improvement, if there is an improvement, that means efforts have been put on. But remember, we're in Kampala, which is not expanding in terms of
space. Yes.
But population
is growing by the day.
It is overtaking the social services that are supposed to be provided, even infrastructure. So the city, within its authority, it is working hard to match the population growth. So I don't want to put a scale of 1 to this.
Why not? You're running away from the scaling.
Not at all, because this is a work in progress. Our target is to hit, if the highest mark is 10, is to hit 10.
But Commissioner, you know, when when you want growth to be definite, then you have to be true to yourself as well and ask yourself, where am I at now? Where are we from? And where do we want to get to? And that way you're able to scale yourself and forge a strategy to get to the ideal.
Absolutely, the strategies are there. And
so where are we at now as you're planning to improve? What are you improving on? So that means that you've already scaled yourself.
Yeah, I must say that we still have a long way to go.
Okay.
Now we are at around, if I may put it in percentage, we are at around 30%.
Okay.
So we still have enormous tasks of 70% to cover. That is maybe a scale of 3 to 10.
Yes.
Because we still have a lot of work to be done in urban areas.
All right. Thank you so much, Commissioner. Of course, before you leave, we do have our man on ground, Mr. Stephen Bide. He's in Bwaise. Of course, I'm trying to seek views from the people right there with regards to the same conversation. Stephen, what are the people saying? Good morning, Stephen.
Good morning to you, Mala. Yes, we are coming to you from Bwaise. I'm just standing in front of the Bwaise traffic lights along this Naweru road that drives the people coming from the other side of Katoke, Nansana, and Kazo towards the city through the traffic lights here. But tugenda kubanga tugenda kona abantu batubulire teka muri wazo duulira embozi bade ko mu studio live. But now, what are the people who are going to be affected by this, the penalties and the fine of the 2 million shillings, and of course the imprisonment of 1 year? Wano wetuli already waliwo kasasiro, waliwo ebintu byakoseddwa amaji, basisa amaji ne babireka wano. Ebimu ku bino ayabisuddewo singa abanga akwatiddwako, this person could be fined with 2 million shillings or imprisoned for 1 year. But ngenda kubanga njogerako n'abantu batubulire bo etteeka lino eryaleeteddwa bo balyogerako ki, balowooza linayamba okutumbula obuyonjo n'ebyenzimba, binayamba okubanga tulina planned well planned housing facilities. Sebo wasizotya?
Wasizotya sebo. Amanya asempira uliyamu.
Mwami sempira, wano olina woteeka kasasiro?
Wano tetulina woteeka kasasiro olw'ensonga nti enteekateeka ebadde tennabaawo, naye nga abakima kasasiro nga abamupatano mutwala gye bamutwala bo babadde bajja, so tusooka ne tumukuŋŋaanyiza mu kakutiya mu bukutiya, naye nga si bibaketi tulyoka tulwako tumuteeka ne balyoka bajja ne bamukima.
Singa osangibwa nga omansiza kasasiro ono nga tenawe omuteeka, etteeka lyongera kuba nga li kuvunaana mu kkooti, owe n'engasi ya miliyoni 2, etteeka lino liraba otya? N'engasi eno ogyogera kooki?
Etteeka eryo ddungi lwa nsonga ki? tituli no bugaya ngabantu songa ate ebintu ebyo fefe nyini fetu bikozesa ngabo ono gama ntosobola genda mukatale no ogula nyama ate no damu no jiteka mutaka ojikuma bulungi paka luokola chi paka luo belanga ojitusa wogendo jirira ne eteka lya kasasiro fenga banna Uganda tuine chejo chinji nyo kyo mtu asobola okujja wano na gamba sibasumbusa no jiteka mukabera akeru nagama nojiteka mu kipapula nojiteka mu kabulaka deni nabitwale waka ne yade mukumalo bitwale waka obijjayo lutalo so eteke eri mbadde nsaba litukwate ko kubaffe nga banna Uganda tutegeera bulungi ne mulimu ebintu bye tukola ng'ensobi sama teka bagana abagazze tujja kwongera mu amaanyi era obuyonjo bujja kubaawo
weba nyo mwami Sempia. Of course we are talking about the new fiscal planning amendment act that was assented to by the president on January 20th, and of course we shall also be knowing this with this law. If you don't slash your compound, that will also be a crime. And if you also build in unplanned housing, if you build in unplanned way, you're also liable to a fine of 2 million shillings. Also, could also be imprisoned for 1 year or serve the two sentences of a fine and imprisonment. Sebo wasizoti yangu sanze utunda matoke wano.
Yali mukade wange.
Etoke lya meka.
Etoke beyo nagu mu kitundu mukakaga mukasanga.
Kakati omuntu singa wata ebi awate toke lino. Bali watide wanasulawo kasasiro guba musango. Government ali sete keteka lino yogera ko kiro kugenda nga masa kasasiro kuzimba enzimba etali ku plan.
Government emekwe kwasa. Kuba wano mukatale mazewe emyaka 15. Na ye wano inongosawo emyaka kubandeta matoke nze kuvembalala naye emyaka looza 15 Museveni yali ankubiddeko omulanga nti nongosewe enkolera
government yeleseteka
yeyo government era Museveni ye government naye ebyo byonna biyekwasa government biyekwasa ffe wano emyaka gyonna gyonna looza era nawo olaba esawa eno yakola naye esawa gyebujja kusawa nga 3-2 kitundu tuba tulongosezaawo nga walungi kuba naffe tuli bantu bakulu wetukwera tulina okuba abayonjo.
So briefly, this gentleman says that whenever they finish working here, or around 9 a.m., they make sure they clean this area where they operate from. But also, wherever you are residing from, if your house doesn't have a dustbin, if your house doesn't have a label, but this, maybe at your gate, that don't have a label of your name and anything to identify you at your entrance, that will be a crime with this new fiscal planning amendment act. Of course, if you don't clean your compound, that will also be another offense. Ngenda kubate njogera ko na bami abasudde wano sebo haji wasotya
ndi tata
manyaga fesebo
ze haruna gamyuka
mami gamyuka eteka lya ze mu makago oina ujja lusawe oina chipipa masu akasasiro
ade sina ujja lusawe do ne sina chipipa nibali tukozesa obukutia teka mukasasiro niyo rusasiro sinye ku yes tano buli mwezi walwe bitongole bitwala akasasiro sasiro ku yes tano kaja tebo mbuda mauli laga malala ndi bagira kutuku ata bagira kutuvonana sinye unyisiza
kakali walo nokubango otambuza bigere ogenda onywa mazi ogenda enabyo olya oboli ku gali oboli motoka ogenda isa mu dinisa basula obuchupa basula kasasiro nogo nago musango era omuntu oyo singa omukwata asobola okuvunaanibwa mu kkooti naawe engasi ya miliyoni 2 oba okusomoka kamulamba ebibonezo bino byaba otya binayamba okutumbula obuyonjo
ekintu ng'ekyo kirungi naye okusinzira ku ggwanga lyaffe lifaanana kibali kyetaagayo okusooka okusomesa abantu n'obawayo ebbanga bali amyezi ena oba etaano ne mubasomesa waka bannange omuntu yenna anaddamu n'asangibwa nga akutte kasooli namawo okulya n'asula ekisasiro ogwo musango kituufu naye kyendaga okusomesa abantu kubanga abantu bamanyi abantu bonna tibategererawo nga bobolowooza naye bwobasomesa n'atukozesa nga tena kiyakola ki tena kiyekwasa
maybe this gentleman here, Haji Kamiuka, says that people need a lot of sensitization before they implement this new law. And of course, he says that they are paying 5,000 shillings for companies that collect garbage. And this should be responsible, not them as individuals or household the heads, but these companies that delay to collect the rubbish. But also this law, the new Fiscal Planning Act of 2020, of course, also talks about the planned housing or housing facility, and it will be a crime for you who goes ahead and builds a house in reserved areas like roadsides. I will also speak to this gentleman, Sebo Wasotia. Ekizimbe kyonna kyonna kinga kisiba nga kizimbiddwa okumpi n'ekkubo gavumenti ejja n'ekimenya oba local council naye ate gw'osasula mu tteeka lino pye lyazze etteeka lino lirabootya
etteeka eryo lyalibadde eddungi naye si ddungi lwa nsonga okusinziira ku gavumenti okusinziira eggwanga lyaffe nga bwe liri omuntu alwawo okufuna pulaani agende abantu abasinga obungi tebazimbira ebayumba gaabwe ku pulaani kubanga omuntu bwafuna yakasente kene yeyiya n'agamba kanzimbe wano n'azimbawo kati enkya gavumenti ejja kujja mugambe wazimba wakyamu menyawo ennyumba otole ne faini ebyo ebintu ebyo oba okalubiriza bannansi oba obakalubiriza ebyagala kale kyalibadde kitwalako ebbanga ne basooka okusomesa abantu munnamanya bwe n'azimba wano ja kubanga nzimbyewo mu bukyamu oba nja genda nsobola okwogera ne city council mpeyo akasente akatono bampe pulaani naye ne pulaani yonna tesobola gyesimbe ogenda okusaba pulaani mu city council olina kuba ng'oli munene ate abatono tebamufuna mpola.
Let me just finish with just one lady here who will also be letting us know about her views about this new Fiscal Planning Act. Nyabo Wasotia.
Yendi Seba. Wasotia Seba.
Yes, Seba. Nyabo teka oliwulidde nga tuliyogerako. Oliyogerako ki?
Eteka. Dungi kubanga obuyonjo bwetaagisa ng'abantu okuviira ddala ewaka waffe gye tukolera awamu ne mu kkubo. Ne mu nguudo mwe tuyita ekyo kyo kituufu eky'obuyonjo naye ate etteeka ndirabye nga ligenda kunyigirizaamuko nga lye mwogeddeko ery'okuba ng'ozimbye ate nga wazimba mu kkubo nga gw'olina okusasulira gavumenti oba tolina n'okusiba kati ekyo nkirabe nga kinyigirizaamu naye ate nga kinyigirizwa omuntu owa wansi kubanga bwe twogera waliwo abaazimba mu ntobazi tebogerwako kubanga ba munene munene naye kati ne muddirayo ddala ku muntu owa wansi ye mumunyigirize so ng'ate yagula tamanyi nti waliwo ki waliwo ekkubo kati woteekako aliyirire gavumenti ekyo nkirabira ddala nga waliwo okwekubira okunyigiriza omuntu wa wansi naye ng'ekyobuyonjo kirungi nnyo kyetaagisiza okuba abayonjo
kyetaagisa ki okuseteeka lino mukola kubanga tulina amateeka amalala. Okay, thank you so much. Webali nnyo nyabo omukyalo n'agamba nti amateeka there are so many laws that have to be put in place. But also the other gentleman was talking about the delays in accessing the plans here in Kampala. This is Stephen Mbido Mfefeswe Chibuga Mbadde Bwayise Nkuba Etonya, but of course people are going with their business. Handing you back to studio right now. I'm out.
Thank you so much, Stephen Bide, for that exclusive. Of course, just getting to hear what you have to say on the ground with regards to this new law. Mr. Emmanuel, to you, just two responses, of course, something that caught our eye right here. We did have one gentleman who said that Ugandans are stubborn and that the gap in Uganda has always been, we don't lack laws, but the enforcement of these laws is something that we never realize at 100%. What's your take on this one? Will this be a different law whereby enforcement will be at 100%? Are you confident that it will be the case?
Yeah, thank you so much. Here it has come out very well that people need to be sensitized and get away of this law. And that is in line with our efforts we are trying to put in place. But the good part of it is that people appreciate the coming of the law and people appreciate to live in a very clean, healthy environment.
Correct.
And which is the most objective of these laws of our effort and to have a good urban environment. So the fact is we need to sensitize people.
All right.
We need to disseminate this law and people have to appreciate.
All right.
You know, this is a prohibitive law.
Yes.
Once you are on the right side of the law, nothing.
Will there be a grace period? Of course, as one of the Ugandan right there asked for a grace period, at least 5 months, for people to understand the law and to have time to comply. Will it be the case? Any grace period?
No, the issue, the law is now in force.
Okay, so no grace period.
So the now the onus is on us to make sure that we have the law understood by each and every Ugandan.
All right. As we come to a wrap, just 1 second. I want you to speak to this other thing that we haven't touched on, yet it's quite critical, because if you don't comply, you'll find yourself on the wrong side of the law, whereby landlords are expected to regularly paint their premises. And that if your premises is actually found untidy, the paint has worn out, then you'll be, you know, you'll be rubbing roughly with the law. Speak to this one. And how do you categorize a building that is not well painted? And are we saying that people now have to, especially landlords, have to put aside now that budget of painting their premises every so often?
You know, when you are putting on a dirty shirt, everybody will say this is a dirty shirt. So if your building is not tidy, it will be just seen.
All right.
And all this is done in the spirit of having a smart, tidy, and healthy environment.
Okay.
And the impression, you know, cities, towns give the impression of a country.
Correct. And the people in
and
there.
And the people, definitely.
Correct.
So, any smart, tidy, and healthy city implies the people are smart, are tidy, and healthy.
All right. Thank on that tidy so note and that smart note, let's say it's a wrap right here. Many thanks for making time. And, of course, we'll follow tabs with you to look at the enforcement bit and sensitization bit, of course, one of the key concerns from Uganda.
With your efforts also.
All right. Many thanks, Mr. Emmanuel Kaganzi. He is the Commissioner of Physical Planning at the Ministry of Lands, Housing and Urban Development. Hashtag Morning at NTV. Continue keeping with our conversations on Hashtag Morning at NTV. Allow us to pay our bills. We'll be back with some interesting conversation. Don't go too far.